am Dr. Suvarchala, Scientific Director with Ziva Fertility Centers. Endometriosis is a chronic gynecological condition where tissue similar to the lining of the uterus, which is called as endometrium, grows outside the uterine cavity. This ectopic endometrial tissue can be found on ovaries, fallopian tubes, the outer surface of the uterus, and other pelvic organs. Endometriosis can cause pain, inflammation, and infertility. Let's look at the effect of endometriosis and its impact on infertility in detail. We'll begin with the pathophysiology of endometriosis. Ectopic endometrial implants and the location is what we're going to talk about first. These implants can be found on various pelvic organs, including the ovaries, fallopian tubes, and the peritoneum. Like normal endometrial tissue, these implants respond to hormonal changes during menstrual cycle, thickening, breaking down, and bleeding. Inflammation and immune response to chronic inflammation. The breakdown and bleeding of these implants can cause chronic inflammation in the pelvic region. It can cause immune dysregulation. The immune system response to endometriosis can result in the release of inflammatory cytokines and growth factors, further promoting the growth and maintenance of endometriosis lesions. It can cause adhesions and scar tissue. Repeated inflammation and bleeding can lead to formation of scar tissue and adhesions, which are bands of fibrous tissue that can bind organs together. This is not a good thing to happen to endometriosis patients. So how can it cause infertility? It can cause by bringing about anatomical distortions, especially tubal blockage. Adhesions and scar tissue can distort the anatomy of the reproductive organs. For example, it can cause blockage or damage to the fallopian tubes, preventing the egg and the sperm from meeting. It can cause ovarian cysts, which are called as endometriomas. Endometriosis can form cysts on the ovaries called endometriomas, which can interfere with ovulation and the release of eggs. Endometriosis also causes impaired oocyte quality by causing inflammation. Chronic inflammation can affect the environment of the ovaries and it can lead to poor egg quality. It also increases oxidative stress. Increased oxidative stress in the pelvic environment can damage the DNA of the oocytes, therefore reducing their viability and capacity to be fertilized and form good quality embryos. It can alter immune function. Sperm and embryo interaction can be affected by endometriosis. Immune dysregulation and the presence of inflammatory mediators can impair sperm function, fertilization, and embryo implantation. It can also have an effect on autoimmune response. Some women with endometriosis may produce antibodies that attack sperms or embryos, further bringing down fertility. Endometriosis also causes hormonal imbalances. It causes progesterone resistance. Endometriotic tissues may have altered responses to progesterone, a hormone which is very important for preparation of endometrium for implantation. This can lead to inadequate preparation of the uterine lining, making it less receptive to embryo. It causes estrogen dominance. Endometriotic lesions produce estrogens, which can create an imbalance, further promoting the growth of endometriosis and therefore affecting the overall reproductive hormone levels. It also has an impact on sperm transport and function. The inflammatory environment created by endometriosis can negatively impact the function and movement of sperms within the female reproductive tract. Also, it has an effect on cervical mucus. Changes in cervical mucus due to hormone imbalances and inflammation can make it more difficult for sperm to reach the egg. Even if fertilization occurs, the endometrium in women with endometriosis may be less receptive to embryo implantation due to altered hormonal signaling and inflammation. Now, endometriosis is also shown to have an effect on decidualization. The process by which endometrial lining prepares for embryo implantation is called decidualization, and it can be affected by serious levels of endometriosis. This reduces the chance of successful implantation and pregnancy. So what are the symptoms? Common symptoms of endometriosis include chronic pelvic pain, painful periods, pain during intercourse, or heavy menstrual bleeding and infertility. Diagnosis often involves a combination of clinical evaluation, ultrasound or MRI, and sometimes even laparoscopy to visualize and biopsy endometriotic lesions. Treatment include pain management medications. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are commonly used to manage pain. Birth control pills, GnRH agonists, and other hormonal treatments can also reduce or eliminate menstruation. Therefore, reducing the growth and activity of endometriotic tissue. Laparoscopically also this problem can be intervened. This can be used to remove endometriotic lesions, cysts and adhesions to restore normal pelvic anatomy. In severe cases, hysterectomy, which is the removal of uterus, may be considered, but this is considered only as a last resort after the woman has had children. Assisted reproductive technologies is also considered. IVF can bypass many barriers to natural conception posed by endometriosis and thereby increase the chance of pregnancy in women who have even severe endometriosis. To understand more about this, please feel free to contact us. Thank you. A lot of effort has gone into making this video. Please like and subscribe us. Thank you.